The new Adam Speedline Super S driver takes distance to a whole new level. You'll swing it faster, easier, and with more confidence than ever before. Here's two-time REMAX champion, Jamie Sidlowski.
When we want to hit the ball a lot farther, we try gripping the club too tight, and we get tense and rigid. What I tell all the amateur players to do is just grab that driver upside down, try to hear a whoosh sound, use a lot of wrist and a lot of hinge, and that's the only way you can create speed. In order to create distance, we need to create speed. We need to be loose in the hands, free-flowing throughout the body, and not get stiff and rigid.
Sidlowski now faces Tim Burke with a spot in the final up for grabs.
Jamie Sidlowski's the biggest name in the sport, and I personally think he kind of brought this sport to the next level.
My expectation is to win. Falling short the last couple years has kind of left a bad taste in my mouth.
Remember last year, he lost to eventual champion Carl Walter, and a couple of years ago, it was Joe Miller who took him out. But he's never finished outside the top five in his 6 REMAX appearances. Well, he's trying to get back into the winner's circle up against Tim Burke.
And this is a big week for Burke, because he told us that he has just accepted a new job in New York City as a financial wholesaler. But that will change if he wins the REMAX World Long Drive Championship. He will do this professionally.
Wow, that's a big, that's a lot of pressure to put on yourself.
First one from Burke is into the houses.
And again, if he ends up playing 6-3 for Jamie, if he hits his first three bad and it's 6-3, tough position. Mm-hmm.
It's so, you know, you can't overstate the fact that to get one of these first couple of balls in play, it doesn't have to be a bomb. It just needs to be in play where it takes a lot of the pressure off the next one.
Another one down the right side. And this one, too, out of bounds. A little extra pressure for Burke, knowing he's taking on Sidlowski.
Playing Jamie Sidlowski is very much like trying to play Tiger Woods in his heyday, that it makes you try to do more than you're capable of doing. And once you do that, you can't make a good golf swing.
Well, they know how much heat he has, so they're not going to take it easy. They're going to give 6 a big wallop, see if he can find the grid.
With the new driver, this one going down the left side.
That's going to stay in for sure.
Come on, baby girl.
Took a big hop left.
Oh, that's on the line. There it is. That's in.
It is in.
About 354. Well, he has waited for this day for a whole year. I'm going to tell you, after losing to Carl Walter last year, Joe Miller the year before, this is a very angry person right now that wants that REMAX title back.
And his first one is a hook, and hooking too much, and hooking out of bounds left. A little quick with that swing. Sidlowski said, for all the amateurs out there, the best way to hit it long is to stay loose in your hands and create speed with the club.
And you'll see the wrist hinge that he creates here using the Adams 9032 driver, the House of Ford shaft. That's been kind of his repertoire now for 4 straight years, the same golf club. Setting it up down the right side of that Penske truck. Try to turn it into the balloon.
This one's going to be in play, but
yeah, sky ball.
A little pop up to the right.
We'd all love to be able to sky it like that.
Yeah, it's four grooves high. And the wind is really whipping now, Andy. I mean, it is howling right now. The wind's just picked up 15 miles an hour.
Horrible break for Sidlowski.
It kind of happened to him a little last year. See if that was just a blow through and it'll lay down a little. He's got to hit one solid. He can get it over 360.
And again, that one hooking left and out of bounds. He only put one in play at 326.
Looks like he's trying to hook it too much.
Take a look at the wrist hinge here at the top. You notice the left wrist on most players would stop right there. Both wrists hinge. Look at the depth of this backswing. I don't know how he just doesn't catch the hat right there. Great position. He's just a little bit out of sorts. Flipping it with the right hand, Andy.
Well, he's and anytime you see a player with his left arm gets out away from his body there, you've lost your speed.
That one again into the housing complex over there.
Well, here's what the other competitors say about Tim.
Tim Burke, our tour championship winner. He knows what it takes. He's
He's on fire right now.
A great athlete. He's fast and long.
He's improved all year long. He's an amazing competitor, has a big ball in the bag at any time.
Look at this wind. I mean, the tents are flying up here now. You gotta need a low trapper. You gotta slow her down and hit a little trapper. Ball six here. Nope, gone.
And another one, gone.
Jamie's got to play golf here, Andy.
Yep.
You know, 355 is what he needs. And, I mean, the wind is just tenacious now. It's
huge,
rough.
Huge disadvantage with the wind conditions right now, but he needs to hit three balls in the center of the golf club and see what happens.
And look at those Adams wind sails halfway up the mountain. I mean, it is really, really rough up here. He just has to hit it solid.
Yeah, you can't try to do too much. Just make a good golf, make three good golf swings and hit three good solid shots and see what happens.
And use all minute 45.
The one thing is it is coming some from the right, so if he can get it down the right-hand side solidly and just turning over a little bit, the wind won't affect it quite as much. Overhooked again.
Goodness.
That was hit very, very well, but overhooked.
That's the shot. You just got to start it by the right balloons, and then it's game over. The ball working across the grid.
The trouble is you get aiming it that far right.
Then you're going
to
block it.
Your tendency is to come back over it harder to the left to even hook it more.
Go! Hang on!
He likes it if it will hang on.
Too much hook.
Yep. It's going to go out of bounds.
This is the final ball, and he's got to know he's got to start that right. And that wasn't far enough either.
Tough for mom to watch this final ball.
Brother Brandon right there, dad, his father Dan.
45 seconds to go, take your time. Regroup a little bit.
And all four misses have been a hook.
It's gotta start at the right balloons is where it has to start.
This is what he works a whole year for, one swing.
And there it is, right down the middle of the grid. Is it enough?
That ball came down fast.
It was pretty high.
That's not going to make it. That wind ate that ball up. Unbelievable.
He hit it good, but the wind knocked it down, and Tim Burke survives in another disappointing semifinal for Jamie Sedlowski.
That's 3 years in a row of disappointment for Sedlowski. A huge, huge upset.
So Jamie Sedlowski loses in the semifinal to Tim Burke, who moves on with a drive of 354 yards, and Renee is with them both.
Jamie, tell us a little bit about what happened there.
Yeah, I just kind of hit a couple shots that spun a little bit too much, but not much you can do about the wind. Timmy hit a great, put a number on me early. I knew if I hit my shot, I'd be all right. But I just want to thank REMAX, my sponsors, Adams Golf, as well as Robert Kent from House of Forge, Travis Matthew Golf Apparel. And thank you for all your fans, all the fans out here supporting us. Thank you, guys.
Any advice for this guy?
Keep hitting him hard.
I'll try.
What are you looking to do against Ryan?
Just make better swings and actually hit the grid a little better. I felt like I kind of dodged a bullet against Jamie. So we'll see.
When we return, it's the Open Division Final between Ryan Winther and Tim Burke, as the 2012 REMAX World Long Drive Championship continues.
Tim Burke moves on.
A huge, huge upset.